Hi everybody, quick little video tonight. Working on, well, self-education as I've got a few new pieces of hardware to work with here in the studio. Pulled up a song that's done but not yet mixed for a client to work on just on my own time here tonight while I have a little bit in the evening. And I started doing a shootout with various pieces of hardware on all the parts of the mix. And sometimes one thing works for one song, sometimes it's something different. But the key for me is to know for sure the sorts of coloration and tones that I'm going to get out of each of the pieces of gear in my rack. So, I'm going to give you a little preview of what I was working on and how it went. We started with the drums, bass, instruments, and then I laid the vocals on top of that and was wanting to try each of the hardware pieces that I might use in that situation. So, here's what we came up with. Okay, first thing on the drums was the kick drum, which normally I would use the DBX 160s, but I wanted to see how the Warm Audio WA76 worked, and it gave a little bit more punch and thump and bottom end focus to the kick. I did not use any EQ on it and thought I got it sounding just the way I wanted. One of the new pieces for me is this Purple Audio MC77. And that with the snare drum and one of the WA73 EQs, just to give a little more bite on the top, a little more aggression to the snare drum. It's not a very aggressive track, so I just wanted that snare drum to speak proud. And the purple is amazing on snare. It's like a different animal altogether from the warm audios, which I think I actually may prefer the warms for vocals, but for snare drum, the purple has got it. So the drum group, the parallel compression group, very often I would use this Heritage Audio Successor, which is really great. But underneath, I picked up for a steal this Dynamite Valley People compressor. The Dynamite is sort of famous for its really sort of hard attack with still really good fidelity, more than the DBXs, I believe. So I put that on the drum parallel group. Was really loving it. So for the bass, I tried a bunch of things. My normal go-to for bass would be either a DBX 160. Sometimes it might be another WA76, or I even tried tonight the JML 500s, LA 500s, which are an LA 3A style compressor. I've had good luck before with the ISA 220s, which I didn't try tonight. I did try running it through the AudioScape Opto. And what I settled on is this AudioScape V Comp, which is a compressor inspired by the Gates Stay Level. I had to play around with the mode and found that a little slower release time and the single mode driven really hard really evened out the bass in a way that I liked and got it to set in, be full and audible without being boomy. And then I also ran into my favorite bass EQ, which is this Cappy BT50. It's this channel here, boosted a little bit of the mid-range 400 hertz right in that nice groany string sound, and softened up 100 hertz a little bit, just a smidgen, to get the bass to really set into the track nice. Then that takes me to the instrument parallel compressors, which could be a number of different possibilities. I have the retro revolver, which works really well for that. Yeah, I do believe that actually it was the Heritage Successor which won for the instrument parallel group. Very present, whereas the retro is a little bit smoother and rounder. So instead, I tried the retro along with a few other choices on the vocal group and really liked what I was getting there. Warm, round, present, and I could sort of dial in a little more punch. For the lead vocal, very often I would do the Warm Audio 73 EQ into the AudioScape Opto, which is an LA2A style compressor. I also tried out the ISA 220s, and the ISA 220s are really smooth and clean, and I thought that's what I would want for this track until I got to hear the Vox Box. The Manly Vox Box just sounded beautiful and huge, and the de-esser did just what I wanted to the high end. There was a little bit of a really wispy upper sibilance that I was having to deal with on the track, and it just came together beautifully. Point of all this is the hardware really lets me dial in quickly a full, rich sound that would take a lot longer to do with the plug-in equivalents. So Scott Fishkind is the artist, and this song was called is called Jackson's Teapot, to be released shortly. And it was fun to play around with this one tonight. So just a little taste of how everything came together in the end. Here's a little bit of the chorus.
Wonder of a child from the place where eagles dare to soar. Imagination taking flight with every passing chord. It echoed through the canyon and carried on the breeze. Jackson's teapot whistled while he wove wistful words and melodies.
Just a little taste of what I'm doing these days at Rooftop Recording. Thanks to Scott Fishkind for letting me preview his track for you and go a little bit into the mindset of how to choose the right gear while mixing. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.